sagen, wir machen direkt weiter.
Okay, so let's continue.
Und zwar gibt es ja doch einige Menschen auf der Welt, die vielleicht schon mal die Nordlichter sehen wollten und
There
diese
are some people on the world that wanted to see the Northern Lights and
tatsächlich
made
schon
trips for that.
Ist und
today we have Manuela Breck, who is a nature photographer and a Northern Lights hunter in
ja,
Germany. Is that possible?
Moin
yes.
Moin aus
hello.
Und, ja,
hello from
ich
Lübeck.
Kurz vorstellen.
How does that work? I'll show you.
Ich fange dann einfach mal an.
And I'll
also
start.
Ich würde ganz gerne euch einen kleinen, kurzen
I would like to give you a brief talk about photography of Northern Lights here in Northern Germany.
Meine Themen dazu, wie entstehen
My topics. How do Northern Lights form? There are sun winds, magnetism of the earth, the meaning of colors, how under which conditions can you view and photograph Northern Lights in Germany, showing you apps and websites for Northern Lights, light pollution and how to photograph Northern Lights. I'll begin with a quick video. You can see a NASA video with a spectroscopic view of sun activity. You can see flares. These are eruptions. This is an X flare. And these are facing the Earth. You can see it's directed at the Earth. Nice.
So.
Okay, so
CME treibt den Sonnenwind
the CME drives the sun wind in front of it. You can see the eruption and the solar wind. Hitting the Earth magnetic field that causes a shock front. And you can see it being redirected to the northern and southern poles. This video shows these things a little bit more nicely. The plasma pulls the fields away from the sun. They stretch like rubber bands. Yeah.
Irgendwann erreicht denn der Sturm das Magnetfeld der Erde.
At some point the storm reaches the Earth's magnetic field. You can see that here. They form a funnel and the gas goes to the lit side of the Earth and they form a funnel and connect again. And then the magnetic field breaks and returns to the poles, and you can see at night Northern Lights here in the north. Yeah, the meaning of colors. Very high up, up to 300 kilometers, you have oxygen atoms. From 100 to 300 kilometers, you have green colors and yellow colors from nitrogen atoms. And under 100 kilometers, you have nitrogen, which are blue and violet. In darkness, you can see colors differently, but the stronger the Northern Lights are, you can see the colors more pronounced. The sky is burning. This was 2013. I changed my objective and had a small framing, and the sky was really burning here in Schwartau. Conditions to see Northern Lights in Northern Germany. Those are CMEs or sun eruptions, little to no clouds, no moon, no light pollution. You have to leave the cities and the light bowl. And you should go in September or April. Also important is the KP index. It's a planetary number. It shows it's a general value predicting. It's not used for predicting Northern Lights. You can use other values for that. This is my first app that I use. It's a traffic light system. It's easy. The traffic light system is everything in red is good. You can see a sweet spot, a speed range on the x-axis. It's about 100 kilometers per second. And you can see in this peak in red, it's very good, wonderful. On the y-axis, you can see the BZ, an indicator for Northern Lights. This is a more recent app. On the 11th, 4th, 2021, we had a KP of maximum 9. You can see the speed here, it's 700 and 800 max, BZ of negative 12. Density, the density is bad. In the green range, it should be in red range, 0. And BT, it's the strength of the magnetic field, measured by ACE satellites. It's nicely in the red range. The BC value can be read like the interplanetary EMF being directed at the Earth. If the magnetic field of the Earth is arranged in a north and southern direction, the on one view, I show you three websites, meteoros.de, or you can read up under Polar Lichter. You can see all parameters on polarlichtvorhersage.de on one view. Before I go hunting, I look at all the parameters and look in the forum and look at clouds and situation in cities and in other countries. At the same time, we can see at sat24.com clouds and how they're moving. And depending on where the clouds are, you have to move to different places. And on Telegram, you have Aurora Alarm, where you can become a member and log in, and then you get notifications on your phone. Yeah. What do you need to photograph polar Northern Lights? You need a camera for long-term exposures. You need batteries that are charged. You need memory cards. You need power blocks and a camera stand. And then you need a long distance trigger, power banks and heating mantles. Heating mantles and a power bank, because if you you might have to check how the pictures are turning out. And back then I found out that the pictures are looking muddy and was thinking about why. And then I noticed that I had condensation and the lens did the lens actually froze up. And that's why I use heating mantles powered by the power bank for warming up the camera. And you need enough gas in your tank, because of course you're traveling in northern Germany with your car. So, hunting polar lights. You need a good location with little light pollution and a clear sky. And you can orientate at the polar star.
Und dann hochgehe zum kleinen Bären.
If you follow these lines, you can find it. That's generally the direction where you can observe northern lights. So this is the rough area I will prepare for. My camera settings. Manual focus. Focusing with a live view. First check with a trigger of 30 seconds. I'll assess how good you can see the polar lights. I'll adapt.
Das war mein erstes Polarlicht 2012.
This was my first Northern Lights in 2012.
Das sind meine ersten Anfänge.
These are my first tries. This was my big treasure from 2015 from the Marina Mountain. I don't remember why I had to go. My parameters weren't really optimal. Firefighters have seen me and went away on their own. I was pretty happy about that. And then I set up my stuff and saw the best Northern Lights of my life. You can see the green homogeneous bow and how the lines dance. That was really nice. Here I have northern lights over the Northern Sea. This is from a beach. I went to the Northern Sea coast because we had clouds. And you can see a nice homogeneous bow. Now I'll show you the dance of the Northern Lights. Let's see if that works. I'll try. I'm starting. And the Northern Lights dance, and if you pay attention, you can see homogeneous bows. I'll play back more slowly. You can see a beamer, and it's dancing here and there. Now you can see the homogeneous green bow, here, even twice, if you look at it, it's nice, it's really wonderful and nice. Yeah, and in the end, if I can proceed, this is my highlight, my jackpot. Jackpot. You can see again the green homogeneous bow, a very normal northern light, even with a reflection in water surface. But what you can see on top is an iridium flare. An iridium flare is a satellite being lit by the sun for a short moment, quickly flashing up, and when I photograph the polar northern lights, I also photograph the iridium flare. For me, a very big jackpot, and I'm thankful for you listening, and bye. Okay, nice pictures. We have a few questions. I'll start right away. Oh, I'll, yeah. Okay. It's questions to both. So Jan, if you are also available, it would be great. I will start with the questions for you. The first question was that satellites from above are also light pollutions. Was that research at all? There are maps recorded by satellites. Light pollution map with ground-based sensors. But there are different websites that are, yeah, there are different maps from satellites, from space. How big of a problem are big constellations like Starlink? Do you notice it? Yeah, we don't really have noticed such influences, but there are observations where groups of satellites being staged. You have a small cloud of satellites that slowly dissolves. And assuming their positions on the
wenn das so weitergeht, ist wird das voraussehbar zu einem Problem, ja.
Okay, sehr spannend.
Kann sich die Messungen dann von euch in der Karte anzeigen lassen, zum Beispiel OpenStreetMap?
Can you see the measurements in maps like OpenStreetMap? No, sadly not. We now also have a sensor, but it's not in use yet because we don't have a fitting housing. For now, operation at our observatory are in macro arc second. So that we can from home decide if it's valuable to come or not. We have a weather station and it's online. And we will add a brightness signal soon.
Ich habe einige Fragen, was man denn jetzt dagegen tun kann. Eine Frage wäre zum Beispiel, würde ein Bewegungssensor an der Straßenbeleuchtung Abhilfe schaffen? Reicht das schon aus?
Bewegungssensoren, die Motion Sensors, die
Hauseigentümer haben ja im
Gegenteil,
die ihre Vorgarten beleuchten, einschalten, um zu verscheuchen. Also wenn man sowas in der Gegend
hat,
dann ist das sehr unangenehm.
So, you have anything like that in the vicinity of the observatory, that's quite nicht so bad.
Astrofotos aus städtischen Gebieten.
Inwiefern
Filter für Natrium und
Quecksilber
in der Praxis funktionieren die wirklich so gut?
In cities, are there to the filters that filter out sodium,
spectrum,
for example, work well. And there are certain filters that work quite well, especially if you're in a city.
They do a filter on the spectrum. Die roten Wasserstofflinien, Sauerstoff, Stickstoff,
in certain
Linien, blenden das Licht
aus. Nitrogen,
das sind also spectra, Notchfilter, die Kerben.
Und das funktioniert auch wirklich
Sodium,
gut, dass man in der Stadt raus Astrofotografie machen kann.
Mercury.
Das ist dann,
and does that work well enough that you can do photography from
solche Filter gibt es in sehr in verschiedenen
Güteklassen. Yes, but it's quite the question of how much we'll spend. There are obviously different classes.
Umso besser kann ich alles andere ausblenden.
The better the bandwidth, the more money you spend, the better the resulting picture is going to be. But
prices
really do trouble
or
unreachable.
So
I would suggest doing the questions in the extended Q&A. Michaela, can you hear me? I have some more questions for you.
Gerne.
Super.
Yeah.
Und zwar, was ist dann, oder was können wir im Verlauf der anwachsenden Aktivität der Sonne in den nächsten Jahren eigentlich dann erwarten?
The increased intensity of the sun, what kind of polar life can we expect?
Es wieder ständig an, also es gibt
so increasing und, currently quite a bit. There's going to be a lot of eruptions and we're going to hit the max.
Ja,
sure.
Ist, ich, immer der Zyklus, ne?
Genau. So every 11 years,
ich jetzt nachrechnen. Also wir hatten jetzt,
there should be the apex.
Also,
2014, I believe,
ja,
was,
aber,
there was an apex for about 2 years.
24, aber, das ist
so 24, 25 maybe,
doch,
but it's not as strict as you. Sun will do whatever it wants.
Die Sonne beobachten und dann entscheiden und dann raus.
Observe the sun and enjoy what
denn, oder gibt es eine Gefahr, die von der Sonne ausgeht für unsere Satelliten?
Is there a danger for us for the electricity supply for satellites?
Eruptionen werden, ja,
yes,
könnten da schon Störungen auftreten,
eruption, that could cause problems, but there's, but
denke ich mal nicht.
Also I don't think there is any danger of a very
high risk
situation or like a very strong
disturbance.
And it's obviously quite nice every now and then if you have to take a break from diesen Mythen gewöhnen.
Sowas wie jetzt leider auch nicht, ne?
Enjoy the time off from the
sun. Wie oft siehst du denn Polarlichter in Deutschland? Oder wie oft kann man die sehen?
How often do you observe polar lights?
How often can they be observed? Das ist ja, wie gesagt, abhängig von den Parametern, wie ich das
schon gehört habe. Und wenn es eine Sonneneruption
auf der Sonne gegeben hat,
dann ist es ungefähr about
paar Tage,
kommt drauf an, wie schnell
der Sonnenwind ist und
wie ausgerichtet der BZ ist,
ist es südlich ausgerichtet, dann
and it also depends on the directionality, if it's the angle towards the southern hemisphere, and I'm just going to observe for a few days, and if the parameters rise,
also das ist sehr, sehr gut zu sehen, halt, wie gesagt, das
you can usually see it quite clearly, just as I explained, in relation to the app,
you look at the website,
especially if you look at the NASA page, they have the preview for the solaruption.
You can plan ahead.
Would it also work from south from Germany, or would that be a
problem?
It depends on how strong the polar light is. We have already observed it in the south in the past. It's strong. Especially if you have a clouded sky and warmth, then maybe there might even be a situation where the south can see it and the north doesn't. So before we now go into the extended Q&A, we've seen in the video that they've been dancing quite quickly. Was that a time lapse? Yeah, obviously. I wrapped the time up quite a bit, and this is actually using quite longer.
Ist langsamer und
aber es ist toll zu sehen. Really
deswegen habe ich auch einmal eingegriffen, um das ein bisschen zu zeigen, um ein bisschen langsamer zu
sein. I just want to show it to you. In its totality, obviously, that needed to be faster. That's why I also zoomed in a little so you can.